Hey guys, welcome to another JavaScript tutorial. This is Eddie the Magic Monk. So what we'll do first today is show you guys the end product after today's lesson. So what we're aiming to create is make a quick quiz for maths. So here are just some simple numbers, adding numbers together, and as you can see, after each question there's a text box. So if I type in the numbers after the text box and let's say I get them all correct, okay, and then I type in check answers and it tells me that I'm all correct. Now what if I get an answer wrong? So for example, if I put here 2 plus 5 is 10, then I check answers, it tells me that question 4 is incorrect. Otherwise, if I fix it, it tells me I'm all correct again. Okay, so that's what we want to achieve by the end of this lesson. If you think that you already know how to do that, feel free to get it done yourself and skip the video. Otherwise, here are the instructions on how we're gonna achieve that. So this is where we were at the end of our last lesson. And we generated all of these questions, but we didn't have any place to enter the answers. So the first thing we want to do is cut this 20 questions down to 5, right? Because it's sort of easier to manage. So now that there are only 5 questions, I want to change it so that this text box appears after every single question instead of appearing at the end. So I'm gonna get rid of the code that tells me that it's appearing at the end. Okay, get rid of that. So now the text box is gone completely. And I want to dynamically generate that code as part of my for loop under the script section that generates these questions. So actually, I'm going to get that code back. So I'm going to cut this. And I'm going to paste it within the for loop here. Now, where should I paste it? I'm going to paste it just before the break tag, right? Because if you have a look, this is where we wrap lines after we generate the code for each question. So number one is our first number, plus number 2, which is our second number, and then the equal sign, and then before I break, I'm going to insert my text box. Now this is not going to work because I have a quotation mark here as part of my HTML code. Now to make JavaScript recognize that this quotation mark is part of HTML and not JavaScript, right, because in JavaScript we also use quotation marks to indicate that it's a string, but this quotation mark here is part of HTML. So if we don't tell JavaScript that, it's going to assume that this is the end of our string. So I'm going to put in the forward slash in front of every quotation mark that I see that is part of the HTML tag. Okay, so now it knows that this whole thing is an HTML tag, and you can see that this is all grayed out. Okay, that means that it's recognized that as HTML and not JavaScript. Okay, so I'm gonna save this and I'll refresh this, and you can see now after every single question is a text box. And now the most important part of this lesson is that instead of using a single variable that contains our number and replacing the number each time, I'm going to have what's called an array of numbers. Okay, so basically it's one single variable with a lot of different compartments where we can store the information. So all the numbers will be stored in different positions in one variable. So I'm going to create this variable called number one, and I'm going to declare as an array. Okay, so it'll be a collection of numbers now rather than just one single number. And then the same thing with number two, it's another array. So now instead of making number one equal to all of this, I can now say the ith element of that array is equal to this number. Okay, so what that means is all of these numbers will be stored in array. In the array, instead of wiping them out every time, they will still be existing in that array, which is really useful. Okay, and then so every time you see number one and two, I'm going to add in another I letter after it, enclosed by the squared brackets. So that shows that it's an array. And so we have a for loop, and when the for loop gets to that number in I, it's going to access that position in the array and allocate this value to that position. Okay, so if I save this now and I refresh, everything still works, right? Because I haven't programmed the checking button to work with the array. Okay, now let's check the answer. Now this is now going to check all of the answers. So instead of saying check the final question, I'm now going to say check answer, and I'm going to edit the code at the bottom so that it will retrieve whatever I have typed in that text box. Okay, so firstly, I'm going to have to name each of these text boxes differently. Now, right now in the code, I'm naming them all as name. So rather than just naming them all with one name, I'm now going to use my for loop as part of the naming process for the input box. So now, rather than just name, I'm going to go name plus I, and then plus quotation mark. So what this does is each text box is now going to be named with name plus whatever number we are on in the for loop. Okay, so what's going to happen is I'm now going to get that element. So I'm going to use a for loop in the function as well for checking the answers. Okay, so I'm going to use a for loop here, and I'm going to declare another variable. So I'm going to say for variable j is equal to 0, and j is smaller than 5, j plus plus. Okay, and I'm going to close the for loop here at the bottom. Okay, so what's going to happen is I'm going to cut this code here for assigning the contents of the text box to my variable. I'm going to cut it and paste it inside my for loop, and I'm going to access that element, that text box, by doing this plus j in the element code. So what this does is it retrieves the information from each of these boxes at this number j. So starting with j is equal to 0, it'll retrieve that information, put it in this text box, and then it'll check that information against number 1 and number 2 added together. Or make sure you put bracket j after the number variables so that you are adding the numbers in that correct position in the number 1 and 2 arrays. And we're going to check y against that answer and see if it's correct or not. Okay, so if I save this and I refresh, okay, and I type, let's say 14 here. Well, actually, let's just do the last one. So let's type 11 here. Tells me my answer is wrong, but if I type 10 here, tells me my answer is correct. Now, what if I put the number in the last, second to last one, but I put it wrong, okay, 8 plus 9 is obviously not 16, it still tells me I'm correct. Why is that? Okay, because of this code here, it's replacing whatever my message was before, okay, for the previous few questions with the answer for the final question. Okay, so the way to fix that is, instead of equals here, I'm going to put in plus equals. And rather than saying, just saying your answer is correct, I'm gonna say your answer is correct in question, and I'm gonna plus the J variable. Okay, your answer is wrong in question, and I'm gonna plus the J variable. Okay, so what's gonna happen is, it should check whether my answer is correct and tell me if I'm right or wrong in each question. Okay, so if I put 13 there and I put this as 5, it should tell me which ones I got answer incorrectly. So it says your answer is correct in question 0, your answer is wrong in question 1. So as you can see here, my answer is correct here, my answer is wrong here, my answer is correct here, my answer is correct here, my answer is wrong here. So it's told me all of the information, not very well formatted, but it has told me. So what I'm going to do is make it better formatted by adding a BR tag at the end. And I'm also going to add another piece of code that when the output name is pressed, I'm going to make the demo section of my page, which is down below here. So that's where all of this text is being outputted to, and I'm gonna make it equal to an empty string. Okay, so when this code is pressed, sorry, when this button is pressed, initially this space will be empty. Oops. So not sure what went wrong there, so just make sure you have this code correctly typed out here. And then I'm gonna click check answer. So refresh. Okay, so I'm gonna 14, 18, 15, just type some ridiculous answers there. It says my answer is correct in question 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I want to display the question number in front as well. So here, instead of making variable I starting at 0, I'm gonna make it start at 1 and make it smaller than or equal to 5. Okay, and then same thing down here, starting at 1 and make it smaller than or equal to 5. And here in the output for the question, I'm gonna make it display question plus the number of the for loop that we're up to right now, the number inside the for loop we're up to right now, plus a quotation mark and the colon. So that will add in front of every question, okay, the question number. So if I refresh now, it tells me question 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and if you put in some numbers here, okay, I did the last two wrong deliberately. It tells me my answer is correct in question 1, 2, 3. My answer is wrong in question 4 and 5. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you again next time.